gave the witness in word. He gave the witness in signs and wonders. He gave the witness in showing his love. He gave the witness in forgiving sinners. He gave the witness, and the Father gave the witness that this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. But that work of witnessing still continues. It's not finished yet. That work of soul winning, it continues. It has not finished yet. And that work of preaching and proclaiming the truth, the glad news, and bringing people into the kingdom, that has not finished yet. That's why it says, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Well, we'll do it. Now we're talking about the unfinished work of Christ. He began it, he didn't finish. Teaching that he began, evangelization that he began, giving forgiveness to sinners, he began, and then giving salvation, eternal life unto sinners, he began, but it's not finished yet. That's why we need resources for finishing Christ's unfinished work. We're looking at 3 points. Number one, revealed fields of Christ's unfinished work. Revealed fields of Christ's unfinished work. Number two, readjusted focus on Christ's unfinished work. If we're going to get the work done and we're going to finish it, we must readjust our focus, readjust our activities, readjust the things we put value on. We readjust our focus so that we can concentrate on this Christ's unfinished work. Number three, resources for finishing Christ's unfinished work. Let's come to number one. Number one, we're looking at revealed fields of Christ's unfinished work. And we have an illustration in Joshua. Joshua chapter 1. In Joshua chapter 1, the Lord himself spoke to Joshua and he told him what he will do. It says in verse 3, every place the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses from the wilderness, and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your course. The Lord in verse 4 describes the perimeter, the territory, how large the land will be, the possession it was given unto them. And he said, now you must walk through, you must possess everything, and you must disengage and drive out all the intruders who are there. I've taken the land from them and I've given the land unto you, but they're still there. You must go there and dislodge them, disengage them, and displace them while they are here, because I have given unto you. As you go, I'll be going with you, but I will not go for you. I will go with you, but I will not go for you. That means if you're sitting back there, well, I told you I've given you the land, and you think I will go for you, I will be your servant to go and take it for you while you are resting like a master, I will not do that. But if you're going, every place the sole of your foot shall tread upon shall be yours, because I'll be with you, I'll support you, I'll energize you, I'll empower you, I will give you wisdom, and the wisdom to fight against all those people until they're displaced. But this is the territory, and you must know all those territories, so you will know whether you are finished or not. Chapter 13 of Joshua, revealing the fields of Christ's unfinished work. That is not Joshua, the area that had not been covered. Let's look at Joshua chapter 13. And we're talking about the time now, already they've crossed River Jordan. What a great feat and great exploit was that. Already the Jericho walls in chapter 6, everything came down. What a great thing is that already Ai had been taken and defeated, and then the Gibeonites had come, and all those people that came together, they overcame them. Already a great miracle of the sun standing still and the moon standing still so that Joshua could finish in the battle. All those things have taken place, and yet after all those signs and wonders and great exploits they did for the Lord in taking all that they took, look at chapter 13 verse 1. Now Joshua was old and stricken in years, and the Lord said, unto him, thou art old and stricken in years, and there remaineth yet, tell me, very much land to be possessed. Where they could have been rejoicing and singing hallelujah and celebrating, thinking, we have done it. We have conquered all those big places, and those Jericho walls, they have come down, and we possess this and possess this and possess this. The Lord, who knows the territory that he has given, he said, Joshua, you're old and you're well stricken in years, and yet there is yet very much, not just much, but very much land to be possessed. Look at verse 2. This is the land yet remaining, that remaineth, all the borders of the Philistines, all Geshurai, and then he goes on verse 3, and then verse 4, and then verse 5, still telling them all the land that remains to be possessed. And then in verse 6, the part that remains to be possessed, it says in verse 7, now therefore divide this land for an inheritance unto the nine tribes, and then he goes on with whom, then he goes on again, so that they'll be able to receive their inheritance. You know what they have done at this time? All of them were all together to conquer Jericho, everybody together to conquer Ai, all the army, all the troops, all the soldiers together. And then in chapter 10, everybody together. And then the Lord was telling Joshua, you know what? As all of you just went as a team, all together, and then you are thinking you're going to cover the land that way, can I give you strategy? Can I give you resources? Can I tell you how you are going to be able to cover the whole land? That's why it says in verse 7, you will be now, therefore, at this time now, you are getting old, well stricken in years, and there's still yet much land to be possessed. If you continue in the same way, and then everybody will go here, and how many years do you have left? That everybody will say, stay together, do this, after we finish, we rest a little, everybody together, do, divide the land, and you divide it unto them, and when you do that, each division will then concentrate on the portion, on the part that is given unto them as an assignment, and then they will get the work done in quicker time. And that's why the Lord is saying we need to readjust our focus, and readjust our methodology, readjust the way we've been doing it. You know, there are some people, they don't understand, and they're just saying, but God gave us this, all doing it together, and there was no done, discipling the whole nation, no strategy, we just did it and did it and did it. Look at Jericho walls, is that already? Was that done at that time? And look at Ai, look at how it came down. Was that done at that time? And look at this, and look at this, and everything was, there was a kind of, we defeated them. And the Lord is saying, okay, after you've done all that, but look at the much land that remains. Don't you know now you need to readjust your focus, and see that this is the way that you'll be able to capture everything now. I pray we will do it. I said we will do it. Chapter 18, Joshua chapter 18, I'm reading from verse 3, Joshua chapter 18 verse 3. And Joshua said unto the children of Israel, how long are ye slack to go to possess the land which the Lord God of your fathers has given you? He himself now, he saw the point. He has divided it unto them. And instead of everybody rising up immediately and getting it done, and Joshua is saying, you're slow, you're slack. All that we have divided, and the new strategies we are developing, and we say this is the way to go and take the land. You're not taking the land like you ought to take the land. And Joshua said, how long are you slack to go to possess the land which the Lord God of your fathers has given you. Give out from among you 3 men for each tribe, and I will send them, and they shall rise and go through the land and describe it according to the inheritance of them, and they shall come again unto me. And do you know what is happening here? When they were at the border of the land in chapter 2, they said Joshua selected 2 people to represent all the nation, the whole nation of Israel, and see what the Lord has given to us. Everything was being done like, you know, we're all together. And it is one single person that is trying to say, now I choose these 2. And they went through the land and then they came back. And they didn't even go too far because they just remained in the inn where Rahab was. And then Rahab said, you don't even need to go further, I'll tell you. The hearts of all the people are melted because of you. Because we know the Lord has given you the land. And then they came back and they said, the hearts of the people are melted. But you know, at this time now, he divided the land. This is your portion. That's your portion. That's your portion. That's your portion. Now he said, I'm not going to choose 2 people. To represent the whole nation now, each of these sections, you choose 3 men. You choose 3 men. You choose 3 men to go and examine your own territory. Go and make your own research. And go and make your own survey. That's what the Lord is telling us now. They were readjusting their focus and their method and their approach so that all this land still remaining, they'll be able to have. We're going to have them in Jesus' name. And now I want to come to Acts of the Apostles. We're looking at the New Testament now. In the New Testament, I'm sure you know that when you come to the Acts of the Apostles, you come to chapter 2. I'm not reading chapter 2 now. I'm actually going very far into the Acts of the Apostles. When you read chapter 2 and you find Peter rising up and then 3,000 becoming converted from all those nations that they came to Jerusalem. What a great revival. And then you look at chapter 3. Silver and gold have I none. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And that man rose up. As a result of that, we're told in chapter 4 verse 4 that 5,000 came to know the Lord. And then you have chapter 5. And Peter was walking like this, and his shadow was healing the sick, and multitudes are being added to the church. You come to chapter 6, and many of the priests were obedient to the faith, and the number of disciples multiplied greatly in Jerusalem. And then you come to chapter 7, the martyrdom of Stephen. And then we're told in chapter 8, and all that was scattered abroad, they went everywhere preaching the word. You come to chapter 9, and then Dorcas came, he was raised from the dead, and then that whole city around there, people believed on the Lord. And then chapter 10, you understand how Cornelius, he said, we're all here to hear everything that you have to tell us. And then as he was speaking like this, the Holy Ghost came down. Oh, we're seeing now, since all that has happened, it's like Peter has finished everything. It's like all these 12 apostles, they finish everything. Now we come to chapter 22. Chapter 22, far into the Acts of the Apostles, when all those great things, wonderful things have happened. Very much land yet to be possessed. That if we're looking at the past, this has been done, that has been done. It's like we're going to just rest back and feel that everything is fully done. Acts of the Apostles chapter 22 in verse 21. And he said unto me, that's the Almighty God, that's the Lord himself, calling Paul the Apostle. And you know, he was converted much, much later. It's like, you know, you are just converted. Now we finished everything before you came. Before you came into the kingdom, I'm telling you that a lot has happened already in Jerusalem, in Samaria, in this place and that place, and the people scattered abroad, and they preach everywhere, and you are just coming. What do you have to do? There's still much. There's still much for somebody even getting converted today. For somebody just coming into the team of leadership and workers like Paul the Apostle. Still much to be done. Acts chapter 22 and in verse 21. And he said unto me, depart, for I will send thee far. Hence unto the Gentiles. The people that were living far away, the Gentiles, they're not living in Jerusalem, they're not living in Judea, they're not living in Samaria, the uttermost part of the earth. In fact, we have more of the population in all those places far unto the Gentiles, more than you have in Jerusalem or Judea or Samaria. The greater part of the populace had not been rich, the greater part of the world had not been rich, even though those great things have happened. And the Lord was telling Paul, like he told Joshua, there is yet very much land to be possessed. In Romans chapter 15, I'm reading from verse 21. Romans chapter 15, revealing the fields of Christ's unfinished work. Revealing all the areas that have not been covered, that still need to be covered. We're looking at Romans chapter 15 and reading from verse 21. But as it is written, to whom he was not spoken of, they shall see, and they that have not heard shall understand. For which cause also I have been much hindered from coming to you. Paul the apostle told the people, the believers in Rome, he said, you know, there's so much land, there's so many people. In fact, I wanted to come to you in Rome, but I just couldn't, because I've been hindered from coming, because people that have never heard. Are you not surprised that all the things that have happened were coming from Acts chapter 1 all through to Acts chapter 9 before he was born again, all through to Acts chapter 10, verse 11, chapter 11, chapter 12. And there are people that have not heard. And he said, that's the reason I've not been able to come to you. How many people are still outside? You have more outside. The people that are born again, that is, those who are not born again, they are more in number than those who are born again in our country. You go to Ghana, you go to Sierra Leone, you go to Liberia, you go to Burkina Faso, you go to Togo, you go to Benin Republic, you go to Niger Republic, and you go to Mali, you go to Mauritania, you go to all those countries, West Africa, East Africa, Central Africa, Southern Africa, Northern Africa, and think about the people that have not really had the real gospel and the true gospel. And if you look at the people that are born again in any of those countries, they're the minority. You're still of the vast majority that do not know the Lord yet. That's why the Lord is saying there's still yet much land. This is not the time to, you know, just to sit back and say, we've done this, we're going to do more. I said we're going to do more because of Christ's unfinished work. We're looking at the word of God here in Matthew chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 35.